Assalamu alaikum. I'm Umer Farooq, and in this video, I'm going to tell you how an enhanced dynamic wedge works and how it's better than a physical wedge. And by the end of the video, I'm going to also give you some examples based on its working. Let's see how it works. So there are two phases of the working of enhanced dynamic wedge. The first phase is known as the open field phase, and the second phase is known as the jaw moving phase. Okay. During the first phase, the photons will be emitted from the source, and these Y1 and Y2 jaws, which are used for the working of enhanced dynamic wedge, are going to remain open for the field that you have set. Okay, these photons will be projected on this radiochromic film, which is initially orangish in color. So as these photons are being projected on this radiochromic film is going to turn a little grayish. And after it enters the second phase, which is the jaw moving phase, one of the jaw is going to move and it's going to close while the photons are still being emitted. And as this jaw closes, we are going to see that one part of the radiochromic film is going to become more darker as compared to the other. And there's going to be a gradient kind of a look on this radiochromic film. Okay. How is an enhanced dynamic wedge better than a physical wedge? There are three main reasons for this. The first reason is that there is no additional scatter due to an enhanced dynamic wedge. So we just have the X and Y jaws involved, and therefore there is not going to be a huge amount of scatter. But since if we use a physical wedge, in the case of a physical wedge, the thinner part of the wedge is going to have a lot of scattering coming out of it, and the thicker part is going to have a little less scattering coming out of it. But all this scattering is going to result into an increased dose to the patient and to other parts of the patient body, except for the ones that we are focused on treating. The second reason why it's better is because there is less physical involvement. And since there is less physical involvement, there are less chances of any error being made. The patient's safety is going to be better in the case of an enhanced dynamic wedge as compared to a physical wedge, because there is absolutely no chance of a wedge falling on the patient while the treatment is going on. And there is going to be less strain to the radiation therapy technologist who is working on the machine. Then the last reason is that there is absence of beam hardening. We know that when there is a filter attached in the beam's projection, that filter or any metallic filter is going to make the beam harder. And since we are having a wedge in place in the projection of the beam, it's going to make it more harder, which means that there are going to be photons of the lesser energies are going to be stopped more often, and only the photons of very high energy are going to get passed through the wedge. And therefore we can see that there is some beam hardening over here shown in this diagram, in which this blue line is showing the enhanced dynamic wedge and the reddish line is showing the physical wedge. And over here we can see that there is more dose over here by the physical wedge on this edge as compared to the enhanced dynamic wedge, and this is due to the beam hardening on the thinner end of the wedge filter. Okay, now let's see how to use an enhanced dynamic wedge. So to use an enhanced dynamic wedge, we need to theoretically use these two angles. The first is known as the hinge angle. So this phi is denoting the hinge angle over here, and theta over here is showing the wedge angle. Okay, so the thing with enhanced dynamic wedge is that if you increase the hinge angle, if you increase this phi, you will have to decrease this wedge angle. So as this phi increases, the wedge angle is going to decrease. And if you decrease it, if you increase the hinge angle even further, the wedge angle is going to decrease further. Okay, that practically means that for a 180 degree hinge, there is going to be 0 degrees of wedge that you need to apply on either end. Okay, there are some examples of its working that I promised to show you by the end of the video. So I have some pictures of the enhanced dynamic wedge working on Eclipse. And here I have used a 10 degree wedge, and with that I have made a difference over here of around 160 degrees that I have shown over here. So there is a 160 degree angle between these two fields. And we can see that there is a hot over here. And the 95 degree azimuth line is coming right over here. Okay. Then we have the same kind of result over here as well. There is a hot region over here and there is a 95 degree line coming over here. Then the same thing is over here as well. Okay, we can see the same thing as I'm decreasing the hinge angle, I'm increasing the wedge angle as well in all of them. So as I go further, you can see that this is where I have applied a 45 degree wedge and we are at 90 degrees right now. We can see that the 95% azimuth curve can be seen over here. Okay. And in the next one, you can see that the 95 degree line is now projecting quite homogeneously throughout this region. Okay, now what do we learn through this? We can learn from here that on a cylindrical object like this one, like this phantom that I've generated, in this phantom specifically, if we apply this specific the wedges according to the formula, they are not giving the exact shape and they are not giving a homogeneous kind of a dose distribution. Okay, and by the end I will conclude it with this example where I have used a wedge as a tissue compensator. Okay, so we can see that over here I have used a 30 degree wedge on each end, and due to this wedge now the 95% azimuth line is distributed, this green line, the 95% azimuth line is distributed quite homogeneously. Okay, and due to this, and there's one more thing that we can notice over here, that I have done some over wedging over here, and due to that over wedging, this part of this PTV is becoming more hot as compared to this part, and we need to keep the wedge of such an angle that this part and this part needs to be of nearly the same amount of hotness, because either they are both going to become a little bit hotter as compared to 100% dose, they are going to get more dose as compared to 100%, but we need to keep the wedge angle such that both these doses are nearly the same, and probably a 25 degree wedge on this scenario or a 20 degree wedge on this scenario would work even better.